Welcome to another episode of Top 5, where me and my friends debate, discuss, and decide on the top 5 songs from a different UK artist each week. To my left, I have Sasha Keeble. To my right, I have Chucky. And this week, we are going to decide on the top 5 songs ever from Amy Winehouse. Is everybody ready?
Yes.
Are you sure?
This was my topic that I suggested.
I'm just ready.
Excuse me, sorry.
Okay. I don't want to say this because I hate you. I'm saying it because I love you. You're quite an argumentative person.
Okay. I beg to differ. Okay. But well, all
right. Already arguing. Don't get angry with us.
No.
We're a team. This is...
We're here to just work it out.
This is a group family situation, Sasha. Yep.
Agreed.
Because I've seen you when you get angry.
Can I just throw something out there?
Okay, sure, yes.
Last time I came here, I didn't have a voice. Today, I have a voice. And I just want this to be clear right now. I'm not having any of your shit today, Julie. I'm serious. I'm not having one bit of it.
So serious.
I'm not having one single bit of your shit today. So let's just get cracking.
Okay, I don't like the attitude that you're bringing.
I'm ready.
Are you ready? No, I was sat with Chucky in Vinyl Cafe and he was like,
I'm not having any of it today.
I just want you to know, I'm gonna really be on top of Julie today, right? I really am.
Sometimes she needs it.
Yeah, I agree.
Sometimes I didn't have a voice last time, I've got one now, yeah?
Calm down.
All right.
We haven't even started, guys.
Oh my God.
Ready?
Ready.
Okay, what's happening now?
All right, guys, Sasha hasn't been on the show before, Chucky, so we're gonna let Sasha go first. Sasha, can you give us your top 5 Amy Winehouse songs, please?
Well, I'm doing all of them. We're not working our way.
Oh no, we're just gonna go through the top 5 first. Have a look through, you know, see what everybody's got, and then we'll get down to the nitty gritty.
Okay.
Are you nervous?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, I really am.
Why?
Because I just am.
No, remember I told you this is family.
All right, whatever.
Wow. Whatever.
Maybe because I know that there's just whatever.
Are these in order?
Yeah, these are in order.
Okay, cool, great.
All right, number 5 we have In My Bed. Number 4, Fuck Me Pumps.
Okay.
Number 3, He Can Only Hold Her.
Raw.
Number 2, Stronger Than Me.
Okay, I'm writing these, so if you could slow down.
Sorry.
Okay, yep.
Number 2, Stronger Than Me.
Yep.
Number 1, Tears Dry On Their Own. Oh, we're gonna ravage these. Okay.
Chucky, how you doing, babes? You okay? Yeah, you all right? You feeling good? Feeling great?
Oh, mate.
Okay, let's go. What have you got?
This is going to be political.
It is. I can feel it.
Okay.
Don't worry, you got a voice this time. Mm.
My number 5 is Like Smoke.
Is what?
Like Smoke. My number 4 is You Know I'm No Good.
I do.
My number 3 is Tears.
Yeah.
But by the way, I'm just letting this note be like, there's certain things I will negotiate, yeah? But my number 1 is non-negotiable.
Yeah, no, so
and I can, I'm gonna really back this up.
Okay.
Yeah?
I just wanna start by Sasha saying, my number 1 is non-negotiable and you said that as well.
Cool.
You just put her number 1 at 3, so.
Number 2.
This is good.
Is Love Is A Losing Game.
It is a losing game.
Right? And my number 1 is Rehab.
Oh, I knew it.
Absolutely.
What? No.
Absolutely. Don't listen. I can't believe you're just not even in your top 5.
It's not.
That
Rehab
is
not
absolutely
in my top 5.
Outrageous.
Rehab's not in my top 5.
Are you crazy? Mm.
Are you crazy?
All right. We'll discuss this.
Rehab.
The maddest
one. No.
The maddest one. The maddest one. And the backstory.
Okay,
amazing.
We know you've got a voice, but can you stop hitting the table?
All right, sorry.
Thank you. So what's abrasive.
Yours? Oh, no.
I've got 6.
What?
Well, that's not gonna work.
Of course.
I'm gonna lose You Know I'm No Good. I'm gonna lose that. I'm happy to lose that.
Yeah.
So now I've got 5. So you're just
trying to lose it because you just wanna argue.
No. I don't need Love Is A Lose. What do I just get rid of?
You don't even know.
You Know I'm No Good.
You know?
Yeah.
I cheated myself.
Yeah.
No.
See it there. Sing it more. Go on, yeah.
That's the trouble.
Yeah, them harmonies.
You know.
Touching me, bro. No, I'm okay. I'm okay to lose that.
We'll see what else.
I'm okay to lose that. So I've got He Can Only Hold Her.
That's a big tune.
Tears Dry On Their Own.
That's a massive one.
Love Is A Losing Game.
Absolutely humongous.
Yeah,
was that in your top 5?
That was in my
honorable
mentions.
Sent Me Flying.
Okay, that's a tune. That's what I forgot.
And Stronger Than Me. These are not in order, by the way.
Oh,
what? Mine are never in order because I just don't. I'd never do what I'm asked to do. I've asked other people to do.
Can you just put them in some type of order then, please? Like, okay, yeah, just what like is your number one and what is your number five? And we could just do that, can work. Tears. Nah, definitely not. I'm not making up your decision for you because that wasn't even the part.
My number one is Tears.
Yes.
Oh, and my number five.
Yes. Julie's trying it.
My number five is Sent Me Flying.
Okay.
Okay.
I might as well keep going now. My number four is Love Is a Losing Game.
Mm-hmm. You have to think of the horns in that one.
He's so
He thinks, what's she
don't
running
forget
from?
That, don't forget that she kisses her teeth.
I know.
She actually kisses, fuck, two, this is number two, definitely.
Yes.
This is where it gets a bit tense.
Well, just off camera.
Okay, yeah.
Off camera, what was you saying that was definitely not going to go on there?
Light Smoke.
And?
Rehab.
You're just having a laugh.
I feel like...
Light Smoke, we can do that. We can have this discussion.
It's gone.
No, it's not gone. It's not gone. It's not gone. But
smoke is gone.
Wait, I love this because this normally happens with me in that the majority of mine get picked by the other two people.
That's what happened last time, actually.
So Sent Me Flying is the only one that neither of you picked, but the rest of my five you've both picked, so I can chill for a bit. Sent Sasha, you've got Fuck Me Pumps and in
how
my bed.
How can you not have Fuck Me Pumps on your list?
Listen, yeah, I want to preface this.
That was my honourable.
Preface, caveat, disclaimer, any of those words you want by saying, there
right
is not an Amy Winehouse song that I don't like.
Yeah,
that's
this
true.
This is very, very tough.
And I don't want anyone tweeting me and doing all that type of stuff with their emotions and that. I'm just going by how
their
I feel.
Emotions.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm
that's
saying?
That's what I did in the car. I just thought, whatever song came on and I had an emotional feeling response to
it, exactly.
That was on my list.
Exactly.
You see, with her first album, did you have an emotional connection to that at the time?
No.
No, it came out in 2003
and
I was 9, so.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I remember my friend shout, oh, I'm gonna big up Shireen. Shireen and Chanel and Ella, Mehmet, their surnames are, big up you lot. They was listening to Frank all the time. And I was like, what are you lot on? But you know when you've got older, like having older brothers means that you was listening to like So Solid and like Heartless Crew. Having older sisters means you was listening to Amy Winehouse because even if you was too young, your older sister would have been like, that would have been her vibe.
Yeah.
And I think because of that, that's why Shireen used to listen to Amy all the time, but I was not on Frank for time. And then I was in a girl group for 2 weeks.
Oh,
okay. Who was? No way, I didn't even know that.
We just practiced in Gina's garden and a conservatory. And then,
oh shit.
And then we split
what
up.
Was your role in the girl group, just quickly?
Lead, obviously.
No, I wasn't lead. I wasn't lead. I was like, if it was Destiny's Child, I was Michelle.
Okay.
Ooh, that's an odd decision from you.
I didn't choose
I'm surprised
that role. I didn't choose that role. I was Michelle in the group. I think maybe that's why
how
it
many,
ended.
How many members?
There's three of us.
Ah. Oh,
Gina was sick. Beyonce.
Yeah.
I forgot another girl's name. She was Gina's friend. She was Kelly. And then, I was Michelle.
Oh,
babe.
You had Julie in a girl group,
any videos?
No videos.
Nope.
But I think we've got a recording. But we sang Sent Me Flying. That was one of our like songs that we would sing. And then I started listening to Frank. And that was when I was in college. Yeah. I met Gina in college. So I was like, what, 17, 18?
Yeah.
That's when I actually got into Frank.
I got into Frank super late. And to be honest with you, like I'd never had an emotional connection to Frank. Although I thought it was a phenomenal album, There are things with Amy that like, as you said, her bodies of work are just good. Like I just, there's not a song that I could say that I don't like. But there's like certain songs where it's like some that I just like personally anyway, but then also some that have like the stories behind it that make you understand and like certain things even more.
I see where you're
so
going
there
this.
Was like, there's a couple of things. I mean, there's a couple of interviews that I did as well at a time as well that made me understand certain things.
That you that did
made
or
me,
that she did?
No, who? No.
A couple that, of interviews that she did?
No, that, I, that someone, like someone who was working with her or whatever.
Right.
Would tell me certain things and I'd go back and I'd listen and then I'd listen again, then I'd listen again, then I'd listen again, then I'd just love it even more and more because I understand certain things more. So for me, my list doesn't really replicate anything that is on Frank. Not because it's not a good album, love it, It's a good one. But like, she wrote a lot of them songs when she was 13, 14, 15. When she went and lived her life and then came back and did this thing now, Jesus Christ, my brother. Oh, so my God.
So you say all that to say Rehab is on your list. Why? Tell us the story.
Oh, no, I'll tell you that when we go towards the to thing.
So guess where we are now?
Okay, so what are we doing at number?
Where are you, you've got to lose a couple tunes.
I'm saying, obviously, like Smoke. So I am obviously at a minority here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right? What would you two say as your number five?
From your list only.
Oh, well, we going from mine?
Yeah, you just need to look at your list right now.
I know mine. So what do you want to do? You want to discuss my list?
Well, let me see what we've got. We got Tears. That's one. We got Love is a Losing Game. We've got Stronger Than Me. We've got He Can Only Hold Her. And
what did you both put as your number fives?
I put In My Bed.
And what did you put?
Flying.
Okay.
So we've got four songs right now. So we've got space for one more song.
So what songs are you saying as, okay, let's do this. Let's try this one, yeah? If you had to lose one of your songs,
it's a good one.
What would you lose?
Go on, Zash.
In My Bed.
And what would you lose?
I would lose In My Bed only because I love the garage.
So we're dashing that out then. So
the
In My Bed's
got the garage remix more than the original.
Yeah, because I heard the garage remix first. Just like Sia, Little Man.
Oh yeah, that's true.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. I hear that still.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Oh yeah, you're right, actually.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, I hear
but
that.
The actual original of Little Man by Sia is hard.
Yeah.
It's actually amazing. Vinyl, yeah, it's hard. But I just, yeah.
Shout out to the vinyl guy.
Okay, so Sasha's lost one. Chucky, it's your turn.
See how easy that was? But no, he's going to make it difficult
for us.
Yeah,
definitely, because he's got his voice back, guys. Yeah. 700 years later.
Maybe Tears.
No, what?
Are you doing that strategically?
Huh?
Yeah, you're just trying to.
Are you doing that strategically?
What, doing what strategically?
Losing Tears, because you know that we both.
I don't know, I did. What? Why would I do such a thing? Why would I do that? You know me. Wait. Are you actually trying to change? Are you trying to. Are you making something about my character that you already know that is not me? Is that what you're doing?
First of all, relax, sir.
Is that what you're doing?
Secondly,
you know me.
You know that both of us have picked Tears. Let me explain to you, because he's played this game before and he knows, he understands. I want to make sure you're up to speed. He knows we've both picked Tears, so it's not coming out.
Yeah.
He knows it's going to be in there.
You asked me a question.
So what he's doing is he's getting rid of it from his list, because then he still can keep other ones.
Did you ask me a question, though? Alright, let me ask you, did she ask me a question?
I didn't say it has to. Do you know what I'm saying? If he gets rid of the others, then he's basically taking up one of his five with one that he knows is going to be in anyway.
Yeah.
So he's like, let me get rid of that out of his own five, knowing it will always be in. Then he's got space for more of his songs.
Like, all right, so look.
Think you're a big boy because you got a beard.
I didn't say definitively Tears. You just jumped down my throat when I said it.
I would never ever jump down your throat.
So, you can you can erase that.
So you want to keep Tears?
Possibly.
Okay.
I'm just having a look.
Okay. Take your time.
Okay. No regrets and no emotional days, but as we kiss goodbye.
The only reason why I'm gonna take out Like Smoke is because it features Nas, and Nas is rapping predominantly throughout the whole song. So, for that, I'm going
to
be honest, and I'm going to say Like Smoke.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Thank you, babes. That was really, really, grown of you, and I appreciate you.
Someone's got to be,
calm down. So for my list, I'm going to accept that, hang on a minute, there is space for one more. How do you feel about Sent Me Flying? Is that not your vibe?
Love that tune.
Love that tune.
Oh, okay, fine, I'm keeping it in for a second then.
Keeping
it in for a second, because you both said you love it.
But Sasha, you could ask me that about any Amy tune and I'd go.
But Fuck Me Pumps, what's the vibe? What are you saying?
Fuck Me Pumps. It's a song about girls in clubs that are annoying. We all know those girls. Do you know what I mean? Mm. And like,
That
was my honourable, by the way. That was my honourable.
Wait, hold on. My mind's gone blank.
Look up the lyrics.
Shit, man. How does it go?
You walk in the bar.
When you walk in the bar, and you look like a star, dragging your everybody. And the man notice you, with the Gucci back room.
Did you love it when you first heard it? Because I'm going to be honest, that is a grower on me. I didn't even like it when I first heard it, to be honest with you.
That's what you say. But you really wouldn't mind a millionaire.
Oh, yeah, that is
you don't like bollocks. They don't don't do nothing for ya.
Oh, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Did you pick that over Sent Me Flying?
Yeah.
Do you?
Just because it's such a vibe and like she's just such a piss taker with the whole thing and like...
You know that funk, Fuck My Pumps tune, yeah? That like actually worked in a couple of clubs as well. I'm not even going to lie to you.
Here we go. This guy loves to drop his little DJ knowledge of like...
Oh,
I've been travelling the world. Yeah. I've been travelling from Watford to...
I don't know why you did that, you idiot.
From Watford all the way to Jamaica. I've been travelling the world playing some fucking pumps. Works everywhere.
I've
tried it
work a few times, actually. Yes, I've seen that.
You drop it at the right time, you can get the club really bouncing.
3:45 to 4 a.m. If you drop that then, you're good.
Hey, the last tune at Yardie Dance. Boy.
I'm not saying anything. Okay, hang on, let's just do this. This is not a definite, but let's just to find out. Chuck, if you had to pick between Fuck Me Pumps or Sent Me Flying, what would you pick?
Yeah, Fuck Me Pumps.
Okay, yes. Cool. So that's good. So now let's look at Chucky's list. Which still has two songs that no one cares about except for him on there.
I can't, no,
just
honestly.
Joking, Amy,
no,
we
do you know
him.
What? Big and serious, I'm very surprised you didn't put Rehab on there. I might be trolling on something, but...
What, this? Should we cross it out now if you're trolling?
What? Wait. What was you going to cross out?
You said you might be trolling on something. What
yeah, I didn't. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that.
So you just told us you were trolling on something.
I said possibly. Anyway...
No, you said I might be trolling on something.
Yeah, which is possibly.
So what was it?
So anyway, we'll move from that.
He's trying anyway, to lose one.
The Rehab thing, seriously.
Do you know
okay,
why?
Explain why.
For me,
yeah.
It was Amy in a place where I didn't really like that Amy. Like, I love Rehab, don't get me wrong, but like, I don't know, like the song makes me sad.
Mm.
I don't know, like, do you know what I mean? It's just a bit...
But don't you also, love the, don't you love the rebellious element
no,
of it
I
as
do.
Well? Just like. The reason why this was my number one as well, I might as well just tell you, yeah, is because the whole thing of her just going and just living some life, yeah. See, like, as an artist, you can't just make an album and then just come back the next year and do... Some can, rappers usually can't do that shit. But as a singer, when you're feeling things and going through certain things or whatever, you want to just live a little bit of life. Now, look, there's no hiding from the fact that there were certain things that was going in her life that was unsavory, yeah? But look, there's been a lot of artists that have like made some of their best music when they've been on food, right? So with that being said, the way that the tone that this set as the start of the album as well, with all of the things that she went through, just the first line, because that was a real thing. The first line, I'm letting you lot know now. My dad said I was Chris. My dad said I was all right. My dad said I was all right. So fuck your opinion. Fuck it. I'm not going nowhere. For me, that alone, forget the harmony, forget the production, just that element of rebelliousness was not only amazing to me, but quite attractive. I'm sorry.
Where did this go? Honestly, that was not where I expected you to take it. Where did it go just now? I will say this.
Pretty fucking attractive.
You hitting the table was a bit extra and I didn't need it.
I can't, I'm emotional.
Yeah, and that's fine.
I feel like you put up a good argument there.
No, I hear your argument.
It has to at least be in there. Us like doing the number one thing, we can negotiate that. But this has to be in there.
To be, you know what, him saying that for me, I think is a big step because he said it was non-negotiable at the start. So him saying it's negotiable, I think is a big step and I'm going to take that into consideration.
Yes.
However, Rehab to me was a bold statement.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's undeniable. Amy was a bold person.
Mm.
It was a bold statement. The idea of making a song about people saying that you should go rehab and you was like, nah, it's hard. That's like a grime MC. I get it. The song itself though, she's got better songs than Rehab. Like, just lyrically, melodically, harmonies, production, all that stuff, you just put all that stuff in, just rate the song, pretty much all of these songs that we've picked, You Know I'm No Good, all of these is better than Rehab. I think the statement in itself, you're right, is bold. Like, that is hard. They tried to make me go to rehab. I said no. Sick. But I'm not going to, I can't say, just because it's a bold statement, that I'm going to put other songs that are incredible over it.
I don't think that there's five songs better.
What?
Yeah, I don't.
You're lying.
When I listen to Amy Winehouse's album, I'll skip Rehab.
Yeah. Because we have, is
that not maybe down to the fact of how, like, the commercial success it had? Because I do that with big songs that I like.
Because, thank you for saying that, because that's made me sort of, actually think about it. Because Rehab is a way of, Rehab is me telling you what's going on in my life. The rest of her songs are her artistically breaking down feelings and emotions and, like, deep inner thoughts of, like, with metaphor, like, it's just her actual, the way she would write was, and then her voice is like, oh my God, this woman is like fucking in my veins. Whereas Rehab was like, she's just telling me, like, it's like a conversation. It wasn't like, she didn't,
that's my thing.
She wasn't going like Amy, artistic, thick, like she was saying blanket sentences that meant exactly what she was saying. Does that make sense? Like, exactly what she said is what she was saying. Other songs, you have to kind of interpret it a bit, and there's more to it, and there's like ways of whatever. Whereas Rehab to me was very sort of, I don't want to say basic because it wasn't basic, but it was simplistic. It was factual sentences in a song.
It was also though, like really, it was also genius in house, like in comparison to the rest of her songs. It was the more simple, obviously the best, like the one this that did commercially is,
I'm
the
not
best.
Gonna, yeah.
But for me, like what Amy Winehouse means to me is more than Rehab. Do you know what I mean? Like it's more than that tune.
Yeah.
And I just think that because I would skip it, like, I mean, obviously if it comes on at 3:45 in the morning at a club, you know.
I've had a couple of tequilas.
I want this to be clear as well. Obviously, for me, she was more than just this song as well.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
But, like, just what I explained to you was just literally just one side of it. I took away the production, just the way that the song makes me feel. I get that, like, she wasn't in maybe the best space in her life at that time, which is cool because for a lot of the songs she wasn't really anyway.
Yeah.
Do you get me? But like, sometimes you just have to just go with how shit makes you feel, man.
True.
And it makes me feel good.
And you make, it makes you feel like she's attractive.
That's such an odd thing to say.
No, do you know what though? It's
I
not.
Really like
it's,
when she told everyone to fuck off and that she weren't going Rehab.
Sometimes you know when you like someone.
She was super attractive.
I was really attracted.
No, this is Chucky all over.
Wait. It's not even just the fact that like it's the part that I thought was attractive with her saying she's not going to Rehab. It's just, I like sometimes when people are just rebellious. Right. Anyway, within anything.
Yes.
It just so happened to be that it was with Rehab.
So Chuck, you know
so
I'm
no good. Are you really telling me
you know I'm no good or Rehab? Pick one.
Well, that has to be in. Well, that has to go.
That you want to keep Rehab or you know.
I really want to keep Rehab. I'll be honest with you. I really want to keep that. I really want to keep that. And I really want to keep Love is a losing game. Oh my God.
You can keep these two, because we kept them.
Oh yeah, of course.
It's just Rehab, or, you know, I'm no good.
Please, man.
Well, I'm down to put it in.
See it there? She's down to put it in.
Okay, we got five. We got five? Oh, Fuck Me Bumps. If we keep Rehab, we got to get rid of Fuck Me Bumps.
Do we?
Yeah, because there's only space for one more.
What have you got?
Oh no.
What have you got?
Hold on, you haven't checked your list in a while.
No, remember, I took Sent Me Flying off. Sorry. Sent Me Flying has come off. Because you both picked Fuck Me Pumps.
Oh, right.
So, it's between Rehab.
Have you got, you got Love is a Losing Game, yeah?
Yeah, I've got everything else we've all picked.
Okay.
So, it's between Love is a, no, sorry.
It's between Rehab.
It's between Rehab and Fuck Me Pumps.
Oh. Do you know what?
Oh.
For you, Chucky. I'm
going to
do it.
My agenda, you know? Come
I'm going to do it.
See what I'm saying?
Rehab, go on, number five. Okay. I feel like I'm that soldier that's just gone over the front line and gone,
just go, take one. Tell my mother.
Tell my mother I love her.
Is that even the line?
I don't know,
tell
but it is.
Tell my wife I love her. Okay, cool, guys. We have
number five.
We have five songs. Okay, so now this is the bit where it gets really fun. Because we have to put them in order from five.
I know
down
what's
to
happening
one.
Here now. I just know it.
Huh?
I just know what's happening here. I know it. I know what's happening. I know what you love
when
you try and make me do.
I can't believe you know I'm not good at making it in, but okay, cool. So let me put these here. Shout out to
like
England, out to the rain.
Gonna in cave in on, man.
Don't worry, we're going to be fine. We'll make it through.
I'm actually really happy with how this list is turning out. Because it's very close to what my list was.
What was your number one?
Tears was both of our number ones.
I can't spell Stronger, clearly. Yeah, Stronger Than Me. And he can only hold her.
And, where did you have only hold her in yours, in both of your lists?
Sasha's was...
Yours was number four.
Sasha's was number three.
Three.
And mine was two. Chuck, how are you feeling? Just give us like an idea of...
This is going to be a bit more of a battle than I thought it was going to be. Oh, I'm not going to lie. Yeah, this is going to be a bit more of a battle than I thought it was going to be.
Okay.
But I feel like I'm... Oh, mate. And you both had Tears as number one.
Yeah.
So, the five songs that we need to put in order are Tears Dry on Their Own, Love is a Losing Game, Rehab, Stronger Than Me, and He Can Only Hold Her.
Wow. Wow, okay. What's your argument for... What would you have at number five?
Number five is Rehab to me.
Okay. And...
Sasha?
Yeah. I'm not...
Chucky, I just want to say you're taking this really well because that was your number one.
I love the way he's like, I've got a voice today!
I
can't believe it.
No one is going to get... I'm going to really get onto Julie. Well, sir, I didn't even have to do anything. But can I just say, this is healthy. Life's about teamwork and... Oh my God. He's breaking down. Chucky's going to be okay.
It's going to be all right.
Chuck is going to be okay. So, number four, everybody, what are we thinking?
All right, for me.
Oh, hang on. For me, yeah, go on.
For me.
Yes.
It's Love is a Losing Game.
Oh my God. I'm going to leave.
Why?
Are you kidding me?
No.
Do you agree with this as well? You do, don't you?
Hold on.
Oh my God.
Okay. Okay, hold on.
You're singing for each one.
I like it when Julie does this, you know. This is hard for me now.
You know what I'm remembering? When she performed Love is a Losing Game at the Mercury Prize Awards.
Hard.
Do you remember that? And she was wearing that white and yellow dress.
I love it.
I would put Stronger. I would put Stronger Than Me at four, and Love is a Losing Game at three.
Really?
Yeah. Because that, I can't forget that performance. It's just in my mind right now.
Wait, but you would put Stronger Than Me over He Can Only Hold Her.
I would put.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I'd probably put He Can Only Hold Her at four.
Huh? He Can Only Hold Her at four.
Yeah. I put Stronger over that, to be honest with you.
What do I want in my life?
Do you know what
I love about Amy
is the attitude.
Yes.
And Love is a Losing Game. It's beautiful.
Sing it.
But I can't.
Sing it then.
You ain't got no gun fingers. Love is a Losing Game.
Sing it then.
No.
Go on, sing it.
No, we're not here.
Because you might feel different when
you're
singing.
We're not here for your...
It's just like...
Yeah, I love that. You're not singing it, no?
Love is a losing game. What I wish I never played. Oh, what a mess we made.
Join me.
And now the final phrase. Love. No, I'm still down.
Yeah,
no,
me too! Me too, Love is a losing game, but
I'm I'm sick of it.
Now, remember when you got your voice back and you still didn't, it still didn't matter?
Yeah.
It still meant nothing.
I'm down.
Okay, so...
I'm so happy!
Chucky, you're going to stay with us to the end, yeah? Don't just bail out because it's not going your way.
I'm going.
So, number four is Love is a Losing Game, yeah?
I can't believe it. So I know what you lot are going to do now. I know it.
Do you know it?
I think so.
So the three songs that we have left are Tears Dry on Their Own, Stronger Than Me, and He Can Only Hold Her.
I mean, I know.
So I know. Let me guess. let me guess what you're gonna do. I'll tell you what I'm gonna do, or what I would like to do. I would put He Could Only Hold Her number three, Stronger at number two, but I think you two are gonna do it the other way around. That's what you're gonna do, ain't you? You're both gonna do it. No, let me tell you what you're gonna do. This is exactly what you're gonna do. You're gonna, you are both gonna sing Stronger again. Then you're gonna sing Tears, and then you might even try to change Tears
never,
and put out another
never,
two.
Never,
that's
never,
that's what you're gonna do.
Never.
That's what you're gonna do.
Never.
You're gonna sing it,
no,
and then you're gonna change
way.
It, ain't you?
But I think we know what's happened now.
Yeah.
You too, mate.
Chucky, it's been fun to have you here as like a person who's sort of just to fill the seat.
I'm not coming back. Not coming
just to
back.
Fill the seat on the right hand side, because we need a... So Sash, just to double check, what are you thinking for number three then?
So, we're gonna grab the old, wait, Chucky,
I hate you both.
Chucky, if you could just look at that camera.
I don't even like
just keep the camera
like
entertained whilst we, yeah.
I don't like
number
either
three,
of
what are we thinking?
Number three is, wait, what did you say? Hold on, I feel like.
So you don't even know.
No, I do. I've just got confused because I'm a bit.
It's not about you, it's not about
me.
It doesn't matter.
Right,
what are you thinking? He can only hold out number three or stronger than you.
He can only hold out number three.
I know that you want to put he can only hold it at number three.
Do you know what, at this point?
Should we just give him what he
at
wants?
This point,
at this point, people know that, you know, what the fucking deal is.
Go on then, babe. Do you want to write it in yourself? Go on, babe.
Chuck,
do you want to write it? Go on, babe. Go on, you do it.
Chuck, well, yeah, go on, you just write there.
How do I cross?
Yeah, so we're just going to do that. Just rub tears out there. Hold on. Slow down. Yeah, if you just write it. What's going on?
He.
Oh, wow. Yeah. You've written he.
He.
That's not what's actually going there, though. It's actually he can only hold her.
Same thing.
I'm just going to write he can only.
Same thing. You know what I mean.
Which means we have our final order. Alrighty, guys, we have our final list. The top five Amy Winehouse songs ever are as follows. At number five, we have Rehab. At number four, we have Love is a Losing Game. Factual statement. Number three, He Can Only Hold Her for So Long. It's a factual statement. Number two, we have Stronger. And at number one, we have My Tears Dry on Their Own.
We do.
And Chucky
is
going
to
take it away.
Chucky's
going
to take away his rendition of Tears Dry on Their Own. Take it away.
Oh, just so sour. So sour.